everything seemed to be fine. The patient had undergone stroke of the right side hemiparesis. The functional study showed this. This is how he came to us, and this is how he left. He was unstable, and actually the gravity center of the body was shifted forward even more into the tarsal bone. So functionally, he was much worse. There's a difference between objective and subjective. I select such examples on purpose now to show to you there's no use to scold the doctors that they are not qualified or whatever. They base their actions on the grounds of the information available to them. It's not that they work badly. The fact that the clinical examination is very often connected with errors. Another option of stabilometry, axonometrical stabilometry, which as of late is becoming very popular in research, because it is very easily done and very sensitive. And last method that is very important to conduct biomechanical study in orthopedics and in neurology is the registration of pressure underneath the foot in functional probes, like standing, walking, changing the position of the body. This is a typical picture in walking. Without asking this question to you, I may tell you that I've checked with the orthopedists of high qualification. When I show them these pictures, this is also the standing position, and this is walking already. The first thing that I heard from them, without even asking the question, G method, they said, this is the norm. And the position of maximum pressure between the heads of the second and third tarsal bones is the norm. But you can learn this only when you worked with this. And this is already the typical valgus of second, third grade, the higher grade tarsus valgus. 3 to 4, 3 going on to 4. Everything is clear. That's what I wanted to mention in terms of the biomechanics, human biomechanics. Certainly, we've touched upon some clinical issues, but anyway, thank you. Maybe you have any questions? My name is Grigory Wolski from Tumen. Tell me how substantiated is the use of arthrosis for fixing the ankle joint if there is a disorder of brain blood circulation. It's a very individual thing, but if the patient cannot actually hold this joint himself, the main thing is walking and the vertical position, vertical standing position, and this walking. So if the triceps is not working, if the tibiotarsic joint is not working, this is the main method. Thank you. And do you think it necessary to compensate the difference in the length of the lower extremities in children? If it is 5 millimeters, the absolute figures are not very demonstrative. If the height is 170, 180, and there is 5 millimeters, this doesn't need any correction. If the height is less than 1 meter, this may be really very significant. So the ratio of height and difference There may be some asymmetry in terms of the length of the lower extremities, but you must also look at how the locomotive system reacts to this. Maybe there is a certain shift in the pelvis, because the pelvis is actually a balance between the two extremities, and the lumbar section is acted as a compensator. So, absolute figures are of no significance. You must look at all these connections.